What is up, YouTube? It is I, Clutch Morals, and I'm back, and we're building a minivan, or is it a mini bus? Look at this. Wanted to paint it up just like a school bus. Always wanted to own a school bus. It won't fit on my car trailer. I don't know how guys are buying buses, school buses, that don't run, because you pretty much need a semi trailer, you know, to haul them. I don't know. Last week, had a guy message me, he had a limo for sale, and I had him go measure how long it was, and then I went out and measured my trailer. It wouldn't fit. So then I started researching if it's illegal to have a car on a trailer and have like the back tires on the ground, and pretty much everybody I talked to said, we think it is illegal, so I don't own a limo right now. We got the nine wire on, at least the driver's side. We got the cage in. I got the gas tank bolted in. I ordered myself a new inline fuel pump. It's the E2000. The one I've been running is 3 to 4 years old, and I just wanted to swap it out. We got the bumper on. And then there are my upper motor mounts. I've swapped them out for steel W-body. I still have to relocate the computer, move all that, remove the window wiper fluid, probably go ahead and remove the windshield wiper, motor and housing. I could see that coming loose and getting thrown on the belt or somewhere it shouldn't. How about that? I'm having old TRX derby wheels build me a set of front tires for this. I think we're getting the saw blade wheels narrowed with a multi-center and V-treads. So I'm supposed to be going to pick those up one day this week. We got the roof sign on. But here's what I'm working on today, and I've done this to my last three minivans. So I know a lot of people watching this, you guys are not minivan drivers. I am not a minivan driver. I've drove one, and my tire fell off before I pretty much left the line. So, you know, we're learning these minivans together. You guys can learn from my mistakes. You guys can see how I'm doing it. Maybe change it up how you want to do it, you know. But here's what I got going on today. So I've built three minivans, if you count this one. And they've all had air conditioning in the back. And, you know, this is going to be full of Freon if your car is good. This van was kind of old. Wasn't any Freon in the line, so didn't have to worry about that. But this guy here, that's a heater core. And just like the one up here in the front, pretty much lines come off the engine, they run underneath the van, and they come back up in here. So when you have these vehicles with dual climate, where, you know, the back seats have their own heating and air, pretty much there's hot water or antifreeze coming off the motor, running down, and goes to here. And when the back seats are cold, they want some heat, they turn it on, and the fan blows hot air to the back. Well, if you leave that there, how many hits do you think you're going to make before you damage that, and then you have antifreeze or water from your radiator shooting out the back of your van? So I'm going to show you guys how I have been handling that. So pretty much, I get underneath the van and just find the lines. I cut them, put that in there, hose clamp it, fill it full of fluid, and then start the van or the car, whichever you're working on, and pretty much make sure that it's not leaking. And then I'm going to take some tie wire and I'm just going to tie it up off the ground so that if by some chance I lose a tire, that it's not dragging the ground and, you know, leaking antifreeze. Along with building this van, we also got this old girl pulled up. We gonna get the motor pulled so that we can hopefully trash this so I can start pulling out all my parts and building the next one. We ended up breaking the trans cooler fan. I broke the seat and blew the motor up. So we'll probably cut the core support out, pull the motor out, put this one in, and see what kind of fun we can have. Pretty much have 10 days to finish doing my 9-wire, move all my wiring, hook up my fuel lines, figure out a better spot to put that computer, and go pick up my tires, which, you know, I've already got the tire off. Just ready to go pick them up, slap them on. Like trying to be efficient. So, and finish painting this. So, 10 days. 100% doable. Hell, we could build 3 more of these vans in 10 days if we wanted to. So, it's looking like, you know, as long as once we move all the wiring, this thing still starts and runs, we're going to be going to Wexford Warzone. So, anybody up that way, it's going to be in Cadillac, Michigan. If you want to pre-order shirts, now would be the time to hit me up. We're going to take a limited amount of shit with us. So hit like, hit subscribe, follow me on TikTok, YouTube, Facebook, Spotify. Got a podcast, Crashing Into History. We're going to be having more guests on there. So go follow me everywhere but a dark alley. Here we go.